Welcome back to our Sydney studios. Well, Cassini Resources is a wonderful company, base and precious metals they specialise in. And of course, they are doing a lot of exploring out there in West Musgrave, the project that we're going to be talking about in a few minutes. A brand new mining camp with three existing nickel and copper sulphate deposits. And here to tell us more and joining us from our Perth studios this afternoon is Managing Director, of course, Mr. Cassini Resources himself, Richard Bevan. How are you?
Yeah, good, thanks, Benjamin. How are you going?
Very, very well. 2020's snapped into flight. We're already into the second month, and you've got some big news coming off your ASX press release that came out.
Yeah, we have. We've been working hard for the last couple of years to get to this milestone, so it's great to get it out and be able to get going.
It's amazing the amount of research that has to go into, you know, finding all these wonderful places that you've got to explore, but that's part of the game, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. And also with these types of projects that are extremely, you know, they're big, long life assets. So you want to make sure that you've studied them in great detail before you, you know, spend some money and build something.
So for investors watching us today, can you tell us some of the highlights from your recent press release? What should they be looking out for?
Yeah, I think there have been some really material outcomes from the pre-feasibility study. We're obviously in this project in a joint venture with Oz Minerals. They've managed the study and really taken a lot of time and effort and money to produce a very detailed, comprehensive study. So for us, it's a real value point, you know, for the project and for Cassini. So probably a couple of the really key outcomes is the mine life. So the initial mine life is 26 years. There's not too many projects around with that longevity. It's also really well positioned on the C1 cash cost for both nickel and copper, which are the two commodities or metals that'll produce. So for us, strategically, it's a really important asset, long life, low cost, gives you the opportunity of enjoying the upticks in the commodity price cycle, but also makes you very resilient and able to withstand the lower commodity points as well.
I mean, for your company, it must mean big things afoot. A lifespan of 25 years plus, that's massive.
It is, and it is a really big value point. So for our company, you know, we started life as an explorer, and we've sort of gradually been edging towards becoming a larger company and a developer. You know, the impact of that is sort of, you know, $55 to $60 million a year post-tax for the next 25 years. So really quite material. You know, we currently have a market cap of about $35 to $40 million, and that's the opportunity. You know, as we continue through this study phase, there's lots of value that can be added. Mm. And the great thing for Cassini, we've got a strong joint venture partner, and we're not funding the next or the study work. So, you know, we've got an opportunity to continue to increase the value of the project and therefore our company without actually having to fund that process.
And it's the joint ventures that allow you to get all these things happening. I mean, you're talking really in a way that this could be the next mining province of Australia. What towns or what towns around this mine would be impacted in terms of jobs? There must be lots of things that are going to happen for
people.
Yeah,
I think that's a great thing. So this is very remote in Western Australia. We're in the Shire of Ngunnawarra, where there's about 2,500 Indigenous occupants. Mm-hmm. We've had a great engagement with the community, and this type of operation has a significant impact on the economics for the community. So it really is one of the last sort of frontiers in Western Australia that does not have a mining operation, and to establish a mine there has a massive benefit for the community, but also just opens up the whole area, opens up more exploration and more work. And so there's some significant social benefits to this project.
And what towns are around the mine, or are we talking new towns could be created?
I'm not sure about new towns, but definitely we're very close to the Jamison community, which is about 120 kilometres to the west of, to the east of Warburton, which is probably the primary town in that shire. You know, their local communities, they have a strong attachment to the land, and they're very engaged in looking for economic opportunity out there.
I mean, you've been in this business a long time, so when you come across something like this, 25 years is a long time, or it's really a lifetime when you think about it. It must be very exciting to think that even in this day and age, we've got stuff that can last 25 years.
Yeah, I'm not sure I'll be around at the end of it, but I think the great thing is that, you know, it's been a journey. We've had this project now. We acquired it from BHP, and we've been able to progress it in a manner that still preserves value opportunities for our shareholders. So we've had a great joint venture with Oz Minerals. They've been an excellent partner. They've got a really high quality study, and there are significant opportunities for us through a range of different mechanisms to realise some of that project value for our shareholders.
And when you're talking about shareholders and investors, the snapshot for them is you really want them to get behind what you're doing. So can you give us a final push about that again? What's it worth? What's it worth for them? Why are they going to get behind all this?
Yeah, I just think there's a great opportunity. There's a quite a large gap between the project value and Cassini's market cap. We'll close that gap as we pursue some of these options. Some of those options include, you know, funding the project either independently or with our joint venture partner. But there are a range of other opportunities to realise value. You know, the products we've got out there and a mine of this scale is very attractive to a range of parties. And we look forward over the next 3 to 6 months or even longer just to kind of pursue those value opportunities and deliver those for our shareholders.
And then after the value, when do you actually start doing the big mining part?
Well, the current timeline that Oz have put out sort of has a final decision to mine sort of in Q3 next year. Mm-hmm. On the current schedule, we'd be up and producing in sort of the end of 2023, early 2024. So it might seem a long way away, but it actually goes pretty quick. And it's once it's in production, it'll deliver a lot of value.
Richard, thanks for joining us today.
Thanks, Benjamin.
From Perth, that's Managing Director Richard Bevan talking with us today from Cassini Resources. And of course, they're listed on the ASX as CZI.